Jeremy, welcome back to the program.
Thank you for having me.
I want to jump right into FBI right away because I'm sure that you've probably had this feeling yourself, having been in the industry for as long as you have. Sometimes you have great expectations for a pilot or something you're a part of, and it just never seems to get its legs. FBI's not like that. We're coming up on, what, the third season?
Yep, third season, yeah. It's true, yeah. I mean, I did three shows before this, my last three shows, a show called Wicked City, a show called The Return, and a show called Ice, all had never really found their audience, and all three had some really positive things about them. And so I was definitely coming off a run of missing that.
Sure.
You know, acceptance and encouragement so I joined Dick Wolf's team because that's a good team to be on when you're looking to build something that lasts and it hit well out of the gate. It's never smart to be too optimistic about these things, but definitely better odds than most when you're on Dick's team.
Yeah, you can't really go wrong with someone with that kind of a track record.
For sure. Well, I mean, listen, even Dick has had shows that haven't gone. It's a tough world out there. You can't underestimate the sort of the challenge, especially these days. I mean, you know, it's the audiences are smaller than they were 15 years ago for network TV because of all the other outlets. But if there's a guy you can count on, it's definitely Dick.
Jeremy Sisto joining us. It's like I don't have to introduce you because, you know, everyone's known you since the Clueless years, but obviously it's radio, so I kind of have to do that. But I feel kind of silly being like, Jeremy Sisto, you know the voice. You know this iconic actor. So it's interesting because sometimes, too, with shows, they start off in a certain way or a character starts off in a certain way, but after they start to get their legs and kind of go, it takes on a life of its own. Have you seen that with your character changing and evolving with you as an actor, or have you seen in a good way the permanence of your character?
Well, it's funny because I talked about Dick as a real recipe for success, and part of that is that the show is created kind of first, and that doesn't mean that the characters aren't a big part of it, but it does mean that the tone of the show, the rhythm of the show, that's what needs to be honed in on and understood, and then you have the freedom to explore these characters. In the first season, we actually went through a couple of different showrunners, head writers, and they all had different ideas for my character, and that was okay. Actually, I don't think the audience really gleaned that there was some kind of alternating position on that stuff, because like I said, the focus was on making sure the audience got what they paid for, got what they tuned in for, which is a solid procedural show that really reveals the inner workings of the FBI. Jubal has, we just had a great episode last episode where you get to see some of his, the darkness in Jubal's past, which I think is a really illuminating, stuff to see, even though it's dispersed and you only get, a couple of chances a season to really, see into it. It's there in the rest of the episodes. The character has evolved, and I feel like I know him better and better, and in a show like this, it's okay that it takes some time to get to know your character.
And I like that we're actually giving television more time than we used to. I like that we're giving characters more than just lines to say, but really the depth that you're talking about, because not only is that so enjoyable for us as an audience, but as an actor, hell yeah, throw me the hard stuff. I want to dig into it. I want it to get gritty. I want to, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I mean, and a show like this, again, it's like, you know, when the core of the show, the backbone of the show is these stories, is these cases. You know, my character is the central point of all of these cases. You know, all the information comes through me, and I disperse what's going on. Mm-hmm. And so that stuff is always going to be fun. But when they do throw you some sort of more depth with the character stuff, it really is. It's a joy as an actor for sure. And there's less pressure. If you're on a show like 6 Feet Under, which I did for a few years, mm-hmm. there's more of a pressure because if the character stuff doesn't work, then the show doesn't work.
Absolutely. Where
in this case, the character stuff is all gravy.
Jeremy Sisto, the show is CBS's FBI, third season, and I know that you have been doing a lot of press, and you've probably been asked this question 1,000 times, and you're sick of answering it. But how has COVID affected your shooting process?
I haven't talked about it too much, actually. I mean, it's basically everyone's masked up. We can't be on the set. We can only be on the set with the people who have to be there when we're there. And that goes with each department. They're basically just trying to limit contact. So when we do have, invariably, we've had a couple of people contract the corona, and it's clear who then has to be removed for a little while because they were in contact, and so it's all about keeping production on the tracks and up and running. And they've been great about it, you know. And initially, there had to be some harshness, some hard conversations, mm-hmm. To make sure that, you know, the casual atmosphere of the set didn't make people forget how important it is to be really conscious about masks and distance and all that stuff. But we've got a good rhythm now.
Jeremy, I wish that I had more time with you. You're such an incredible actor. FBI is such a great show to watch. I wish you all the best going forward and health and happiness for you and your family until we all get out of this situation we're in. Jeremy Sisto, check out CBS's FBI. Thank you, Jeremy.
Thanks so much for having me.